It is my distinct pleasure to interview our candidate for Marco Island City Council, Darrin Palumbo. Hello, Darrin.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Hey, it is our pleasure.
Really, Mary?
You know, Darrin, we've known each other for a long time. And, you know, for those of you that don't know Darrin, tell a little bit how long you've been here. What have you been doing?
Sure. Well, I think we've known each other almost 20 years. Yeah. I've been on the island just going on my 25th year. You know, and I've had a great experience here. I always tell people it's important, myself and my wife, not only do we choose to move to Marco, but what a compliment that this is the place we chose to rear our children. As they took their first steps here, their first breath. Mm-hmm. And it's a compliment to the island we were, and I hope to keep us. Throughout the course of those almost 25 years, I've had the privilege of being involved in real estate, finance, securities, insurance, developing, the whole gamut of the business world. And I think that bodes well for me to be able to come right into city council, roll my sleeves up and get right to work from that. But right now, I currently find myself as a part owner of Sweet Annie's Ice Cream. And I'm loving it.
Yeah.
We get to employ between 25 and 30 high school and college students.
Yeah.
We have a couple of nighttime employees, cleaning crews and stuff. So we have to create jobs in many different aspects of our economy. I always like to say, as a coach on the island, I've coached high school soccer and amateur soccer and cross country and track for years. I've replaced my coaching addiction with ice cream scooping addiction. So now I coach. We got to scoop a little quicker, you know, make sure the customer gets in and out, but do it quickly. Different things like that. And it's just really been a great experience. Who doesn't love ice cream and candy?
Said no one ever. And I spent a lot of years at that Sweet Annie's prior to you owning it because my kids wanted to go there because of the games and the candy and all that, right?
Well, you know, Mary, I think it's against the rules to buy you an ice cream now because I'm running for council, but we might be able to get you the family discount.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. So, you know, the question I have for you is why now? Why run for council now?
Well, you know, it's something I thought about way back as far as 2004, about my sixth year on the island. And back then, by 2006 and 2007-ish, I served on the Marco Island Waterways Committee. And I enjoyed the time. We did some great things. We crafted ordinances for seawalls. Back then, we had more lots available, but where were you going to pour them? Similar to our rental ordinance, our ordinances for seawalls were crafted where an owner of a vacant lot could allow the seawall companies to build or to construct and pour them, but only two times a year. Okay. We don't want people renting out their vacant lots as a seawall staging area. Okay. So I'm very proud of that. The big one was the, I don't know if you remember, the liveaboard, boater, and mooring field ordinance.
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
And that was just a real challenging time in Marco. I was for it. I was for an ordinance that protected the public. Same with the rental ordinance. So when you say why now, sorry to give you a long answer, but my son is just entering college, this first year in college, and now I have time to really dedicate to the city. I got a taste of what it would be like to serve years back, but now I can dedicate the full time that it needs. And believe me, I think it's going to be a full-time job to represent the city.
Yeah.
I'm prepared to do it.
Well, I love that. You know, the timing is one reason, but the reason, you know, the schedule and why now, but what's your reason for doing this? I mean, shoot me if you put me in council because people probably wouldn't like what I'd have to say.
I do ask myself that every now and then, but truthfully, and I know this sounds, it kind of comes across like a politician answer, but I really feel blessed for spending just about 25 years here. I've become a man on the island. I've made my myself and my wife, our incomes, past, present, and future will be here. Can you think of any better place to spend the rest of your life than Marco Island?
No.
As I mentioned, the biggest compliment when we were choosing a community to move to leave our home state of New Jersey, where were we going to raise children? Where's the greatest place you could pick? And I always say, what a compliment to Marco that we picked here. I don't know if my children fully share the same beliefs because they were born and raised here. But every time we drive over that bridge, and at 18 and 20, they're not in the car too much with me now altogether. Right. But when we are, and when we drive over that bridge, I said, look where we live. Can you imagine we're here? Look at the palm trees. They say, yeah, Dad.
Yeah.
But I've still never gotten over that euphoria. Yeah. Bottom line, I truly want to give back to the community that has given so much to me. And I felt that I wanted to leave it you know, the next 25 years are going to be so much more important than the first 25.
Yeah.
With the growth and with the build outs and with the population. I want to try to leave the best remnants of what Marco used to be today, tomorrow.
Yeah. Well, it's still a great place to live and raising our families together, because mine was, youngest was one, so a little bit older than yours. Sure. When we moved here, what a better place to live.
I haven't found one yet.
No. And by the way, my sons all want to live here too, which I'm really blessed, because they could have gone out somewhere else. And so it's a really wonderful thing for us to give back to the next generation.
I agree. And if I, you know, when you talk about that, this is what I talk about the next 25 years.
Mm-hmm.
My children were born to the island.
Mm-hmm.
My grandchildren may be born to the island, right? Lots are being built out. Snowbirds are staying all year round. We're having families here. Organically, we're going to grow whether we like it or not, and people have a right to be here. So one of my main reasons is, how do we manage that and still feel like small town Marco Island?
Yeah.
It's going to take an entire community effort. We're going to have to come together, put our differences aside, because this will be one challenge that we need to all be on the same page in order to try to fix or to try to grow with.
Yeah, and I'm hoping that we get back to those values that we have for the 20 years that I've been here, and 25 for you, because we've kind of come through some diversity and, you know, people wanting to do different things, which has come back to the council, which I admire you for wanting to step in, because it's not just about short-term rentals, my friends. This is about us being neighbors and being neighborly to each other, which I love, and I'm blessed to have a lot of full-time people on my street, which is awesome.
Sure.
But, you know, I guess my question to you is, who is underrepresented here on the island, you know, from your perspective?
Well, and that's a great one, and I talk about that a lot on the campaign trail. I said, just going on 25 years, I've been in the restaurant business, real estate business, or ice cream business, I should say.
Yeah.
I've coached, I've done beach cleanups. I've got a pretty good background, pretty well ingrained in the community. Something none of us ever talk about, and I think it was Hurricane Ian, made it very popular to bring food, supplies, money to those, we'll call it the 6th Avenue section, Tallwood, Marco Lake Drive.
Yeah.
For lack of a better term, you know, the most modest of workers on the island.
Sure.
But this can't only be popular during the hurricane. This was a necessity years ago, right? We have folks that do the toughest jobs on the island for the most modest of income and have little to no representation. Now we have to understand we're all in this together. You know, what a symbiotic, if I use the word correctly, community where one part hinges on the other.
Right.
So without the workers, I mean, I always say, who wants a $35 salad on Marco Island, right? We're gonna have to take care of our workforce. Yeah. And it's not just the popular ones to talk about, police, fire, rescue, super important.
Right.
So that is one area, the lowest end of our...
Interrupt you there? Because a lot of those folks don't live on the island. They live off island and they commute in. The folks you were previously talking about, many of them don't drive. So now I need a bike or I need to walk or whatever to get to my job, which is very important.
Sure.
And we need to be able to house them and make sure they can, you know, have some way to live here.
When you segue into workforce housing, and workforce housing is a term in Collier County, to earn the level of workforce housing, you have a pretty good income.
Right.
Right? We certainly need to address that. I don't believe there's going to be enough salary we could pay for new first responders, Department of Public Works, the clerical departments. There's not enough we could pay to own a house at Marco at this point.
Mm-hmm.
And we've passed that. So we need to start looking at many other areas.
Mm-hmm.
The Marriott used to bus people in. Mm-hmm. Right now they have a contract with... the Krabby Cabby, if you've seen these around the island, it's Marco Island Bike Rentals, bought three of these 15 or 20 person buses, got a contract with the Marriott, and they bus their workers in three times a day, I believe it is. So if we don't want to expand government, or if the city is not efficient enough to do it on their own, we need to start getting together with the businesses. How can we help you? How can we work out employee housing? We need to start looking at Route 951 and Collier Boulevard over the bridge as our suburbs.
Right.
We need to get together with Collier County, the Collier County Commissioners, because whether we like it or not, we're really kind of in this together.
Yeah.
And East Naples, or especially the Naples corridor going to Marco, is really more Marco than Naples.
Yeah.
If you're, it's really our suburbs to a degree. Mainsail feels more like Marco to Mainsail people than Naples.
My sons both own up there.
There you go. But Tropic Schooner or Mainsail?
They own, I think, in Tropic. Well, I should know, but I think Tropic Schooner. But
did you sell it to them?
Come on. No, they bought it. They're realtors, shockingly enough. But not a Mainsail, but the one Manatee. They own up off of Manatee, which is also still part of our suburbs, in my opinion.
Absolutely. But, it really. So we need to start viewing it that way. I was speaking at the debates last night. We need to start looking at those who have rental properties that would like to rent them to our workforce, right? I don't know if there's some sort of incentive we can offer as a city or some type of relationship we could foster. There's many good people on the island that would prefer an annual rental, prefer to be able to help somebody in the workforce. I mean, we're a charitable place. All you have to do is ask.
You know, that is so true, because after Ian, one of our staff lost his house. Crazy. My customer is putting him up.
You know, I know.
Sorry.
I know that we have to either be, the line has been drawn where you're a yes vote or a no vote for our rental referendum. And why can't we all be maybes?
Yeah.
But I heard some great stories of, you know, some of these vacation rental homes.
Right.
And these are true stories. They're not just for political value.
Sure.
Just handing keys to people.
Yeah.
Without even knowing who is going to be in there.
Right.
Go take care of your family. That's what I believe we're about. And we're going to get there. Once we get past some passionate conversations and settling our differences with ordinances and regulations that benefit everybody and protect everybody. I always like to say, you know, the real question is, are we trying to craft something that openly invites people to Marco on our terms and rules?
Mm-hmm.
Are we trying to craft something to keep people from coming?
Boy, I hope it's open, because it takes a lot to support this lifestyle that I have in this body. So I eat out a lot. And
I'm not touching that one.
Probably I eat at home maybe 3 times a week, but breakfast, lunch, and dinner mostly out, because I work a lot of hours, especially. And I sure don't want those restaurants to go away. So I would love to figure out how to come alongside this.
You know, you're preaching. I bought an ice cream place. You're preaching to the choir, okay? By the way, for those of you folks, ice cream is considered a meal for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. It's a protein source.
It is, yeah.
But,
for sure.
No, but I mean, I don't know if you remember 20 years back, and we probably did this when we first met, the question was, where are you from?
Yeah.
It was the common bond. We all came from somewhere else.
Sure.
Now the question is, are you a yes vote or no vote? Are you for businesses or neighborhoods?
Right, yeah.
We're for a little bit of everything.
Right, right.
I love when I hear, with the great realtor I am, how many homes I sell, it's been like one this year, and how I just want to basically bring rentals on the island. No, I moved from a densely packed area of New Jersey to come here to this quiet, tranquil place. I want to keep it that way, guys.
Sure.
But we also have to realize we have businesses.
Yeah.
And here's the thing, when you hurt the businesses, right, you're not hurting me or you.
Right.
We could afford a couple bucks more for a meal.
Right.
We could afford, I could afford if my business goes down 10%. It's the most impoverished. And when I say also, you ask me who's underrepresented, the second answer is it's the retirees who live off a fixed income that are barely getting by.
Yeah.
Those are the folks you hurt when prices go up or the economy's bad or inflation. And it would be, you have to understand, Marco seems and perceived to be the wealthiest community around. We have people just barely getting by here.
Sure. They, well, they've owned here for quite some time, and you know, insurance rates and taxes, if they aren't homesteaded, have gone up significantly. And it is tough, I mean, from that perspective. So I hear you.
Yeah, so I mean, once we start viewing ourselves as a community again, have a cup of coffee, settle our differences, have some passionate, loud debates, but civil.
Yeah.
And we'll get it worked out.
I think so. Well, you know what? You've heard it here first. And again, it's my delight, distinct pleasure to have Darrin Palumbo, my coworker in real estate for a long time. He doesn't sell anymore.
It's a bad word. You can't say that anymore.
And an ice cream connoisseur owner, and more importantly, a future councilman here in Marco Island, here on the show of Really Mary. And until next time, if you have questions, we'll put how you can reach him, how you can support him below in this. We look forward to seeing you here on The Rock. And you know what? Voting.